And to all the other ones who are watching us, again, I'm going to remind you to join us at openslava.sk, because only when you will join the virtual show floor will you be able to ask questions, visit our artificial intelligence bar, or take a picture in our photo booth where you can use different layers and different exoperamic different frames and make a beautiful photo and upload it for us. Do that, register yourself at openslava.sk, and we would love to welcome you here. But we are going to be moving on, because it's 5:20 and we are going to let in our next guest, who's from Red Hat, which I think most of us are familiar with. I think who started with Linux, I think that was one of the first Linuxes I installed, one of the first Linuxes with a Windows system I used, and I remember Red Hat being the fun Linux to go to. Right now, it's a huge enterprise product, which helps a lot of people stay online and manage their servers, and now we are going to talk about something which I basically know nothing about. So I would like to welcome Stephen Lemaire. I think that's how you pronounce it. With his Madhu Koulibaly. Okay. Yeah. Madhu Koulibaly. Wonderful. Hello, guys. What's with the t-shirt? Is that Cartman?
We are going to discuss about that. Yes.
Okay.
Logos.
I see that. I read your bio and I don't understand nothing. I heard about DevOps. I think that I'm gonna clinch to that. I think that's the thing where you are a programmer and you also operate the thing, and you just put these things together so the programmers don't just send the code somewhere and somebody else has to take care of that. So you have to also operate on your system, which you were developing. I think that is the basic of it. And then that's where I'm over. So what is leveraging CI/CD pipelines with Helm and Argo CD? Can you explain it to your girlfriend in two sentences?
So it's exactly how you can help your developer team to ship faster and in a more reliable way your application onto production.
Ah, okay. So pipeline. I heard about that. That's in Linux. You put this dash, and you can put something from one command to another command to another command. So I'm thinking replacing the commands by people, and with some system, you're gonna help them communicate and navigate the space from the first line of code to the final product easier.
Yeah, it's around those lines, and
we don't want to disappoint you. totally different thing, but never mind. Just close your eyes and come back in 45 minutes. Okay, guys. So I'm gonna give you next 25 or 35 minutes. Please tell us about this. I'm going to be watching you very closely, Stephen and Madhu.
Thank you. Thanks for having us. And for this session, we are two. So I'm Stephen Lemaire. I'm product manager at Red Hat. I'm working on developer tools, and mostly on developer tools that help the developer to better use Kubernetes and Red Hat OpenShift. And we have Madhu today as well.
Yes. So hello, everyone. So my name is Madhu Koulibaly. I'm a specialist solution architect focused on the developer experience on top of OpenShift. And basically, I help anyone. And I think, yes, Yann, we can have also more discussion around that. But really, to be able to understand all the benefits they could acquire by using OpenShift for the full application lifecycle.
Yeah. So maybe now we need to share our slides. Yeah. Okay, so let's move on and let's start. As you know, and as Yann already explained, today software delivery is hard and it involves a lot of different people. But we are maturing our processes and our engineering methodology keeps getting stronger and better articulate over time as well. So most of the time we are aiming to see our code go from point A to point B. Point A being the source code and point B being production. We also know that there's much more letters into these stories. And in order to do that, it's a bit of a long roller coaster with loops, verage, and so on. So today, we also see a natural evolution where developers are required to take into consideration and sometimes even manage themselves the deployment of their application. And that's usually what we are calling DevOps. So how can you uptake your CI and CD methodologies to even more embrace the DevOps culture? And just a quick reminder, we make a difference between CI on everything that is taking the application source code, that is building it, and getting a deployment artifact for the application. The CI will be responsible to automate that process of building and testing the application. The CD is going beyond and will enforce the continuous testing of the application in real environments, ideally environments which will be as close as possible to the production environment. And it will also automate shipping new releases of your application in an automated fashion. So that's what CI and CD are basically. But today, when you are in the context of Kubernetes, there's a lot of new challenges. Basically, the first one is that you need to containerize your application. But containerizing the application and getting an application container is not the hardest part. It's really getting an image for the application, and this image is going to be an artifact that is getting deployed then on Kubernetes platform. But in the context of Kubernetes, the container image itself is not enough. So there's a lot of things that Kubernetes requires for the application so that it knows exactly how to run it. And in order to provide to Kubernetes all the capabilities to properly manage the application, to control its scalability and its resilience, Kubernetes needs a lot of information along with the application. And that's what we are calling the Kubernetes resource. It's usually where you need to manage a lot of YAML files and provide the configuration of the application inside of those YAML files. So those configurations may also differ from one environment to another one, making it harder to automate. And that's what we want to show you today. So how you can leverage Helm and Argo CD to more easily and more naturally automate the CI/CD processes for your application. So in our demo, we are going to be developers working on WordPress application. It's a basic application. Everyone is familiar with WordPress, I will imagine. And for that, we have one application component. One is WordPress, and the other one is MySQL, the database that is getting used by WordPress. The challenge is that the configuration to run this application into different environments will be really different. In our developer environment, the DB needs to be set up. In the staging environment, the DB will be deployed with a special data set allowing some special tests of the application. So we want to make sure that the application is going to be conform to our tests. And for that, we have a special set of tests to do that. And on production, the DB, we are just not going to manage it. We are even not hosting it. We are going to leverage a DB from a managed services coming from different cloud vendors. So in a traditional way, without Helm and without Argo CD, if I want to manage the configuration for the different environments, I will have to handle the different discrepancies for all those different environments manually. So as a developer, I will code on my local environment. And once I'm done, I will push to the repository, to the Git repository, where the CI will be triggered and will build the application and publish the application onto an image registry. It's where the container image for the application is getting created. And then to deploy it, in each of the environments, the ops will have to create the manual configuration for deploying the application on all the different environments. And that's a lot of work. If the application is changing, then I also need to manually adapt the configuration of my environment to those changes and to reflect that for all the different environments that I am targeting to deploy my application on. So it's really manual, it's error prone, and it could lead to potential hard to debug issues. So what we will do and what we will show in our demo is that we will use Helm. So the developer is going to create the Helm packaging for the Kubernetes application. And this packaging will have different configuration options. And then instead of having somebody who will manually take care of the configuration and each of the different specifics in each of the different resources of the applications, we will store the configuration of each of the deployment environments with Argo CD, and Argo CD will then only inject the configuration of the application and handle the deployment of the application for us. So this will be fully automated for us. So I've briefly spoke about Helm, but what is Helm? So Helm is basically a package manager for Kubernetes. See it as NPM, for example, for Node.js application. Here, Helm is really a way to package your Kubernetes application. It's a CNCF project. You have a lot of contributors on this project, both contributing to the core technology of Helm, but also contributing Helm charts for a lot of different application components, services, and things like that. So there are three main primary components of Helm. The first one is Helm charts. Inside of a Helm chart, you will have templates, which are basically templates for the Kubernetes resources of the application. Inside of those templates, you will have some values which will be templatized and which will be replaced by values that are configured inside of a values.yaml file. So this values.yaml file contains all the different configuration options for the different environments you want to deploy your application. And then you have Helm CLI, which takes the Helm chart, takes the values and the different configuration options, and creates the different Kubernetes resources to deploy that onto your cluster. So when you create your Helm chart, you can publish it on a chart repository, and that's what we did for our demo application. So we publish our WordPress sample onto Artifact Hub, which is a very famous and very popular Helm chart repository. But you can also have your own in-house chart repository. There's tools for that, but you can also build one on GitHub if you want. It's very easy and handy to do. So if we explore a little bit what we have inside of this Helm chart, you can see on the left side that we have all the different resources of our application. So we have the deployment, we have the root, secret, and the service definition for the application. And inside of those templates, we have defined some templated values. So here in The Secret, for example, we have defined and we have templatized the different information for the database connection, the name, the username, the password, and things like that. You can do much more advanced things with Elm. You can do conditional blocks if you want, and we are using one, in fact, in this sample. So when you work with Elm, usually what you do is that you have Helm that is installed on your local machine. You will work with Helm chart repository, so you will have to add the repository onto your Helm local configuration. And then when you want to install a chart, it's very handy. You just do Helm install, you give the name of the chart that you want to use. And then you pass the different arguments of the charts, so of the values that are expected for this template by using the command dash dash set deployment mode, for example, equal dev. So with Helm, you have a way to make the configuration of your Kubernetes application templatized. So that is making it very easy and very handy. It is really similar to what you would do for any kind of application, but here it is really in the context of Kubernetes. The fact that it is templatized makes the application easy to configure, and you don't have to replicate the different settings into all the different Kubernetes resources and manifests of your application. Helm is going to do that for you. So obviously, once you have the Helm chart, you can extend your CI strategy, but you can also leverage them in your CI/CD pipelines. And there's a bunch of CI/CD pipeline tools that allows you to leverage Helm, and that's what we are going to see. So once you have that, you can really control the different aspects of the configuration of your application for the different environments within a single source of truth. But for that, let me hand over to Madhu to better explain this part.
Yes, okay, cool. So thank you, Stefan. So now that we've seen how we will be able to package and to templatize our different Kubernetes resources, so let's see how we can move deeper into the, let's say, the orchestration, the automation of the continuous delivery. And for that, we're going to discuss about GitOps. So when we talk about GitOps, so especially in the context of Kubernetes, because there is a really well fit between so Kubernetes, how Kubernetes is working, especially with YAML file, and how and what is the goal of GitOps. So GitOps is a set of practices that's going to leverage Git workflow to manage your infrastructure and your application configuration. So that means that everything that we are going to do, first of all, it should be able to treat everything as code. So it's really important. So the entire state of your infrastructure, your application or your configuration will be defined declaratively and really as a code. So application as a code, infrastructure as a code, configuration as a code. So you will be able to define how your application will be deployed, how your infrastructure will be set up. So basically everything that you are going to have as a code inside a plan plan file. And on this plan file, what we have for Kubernetes, so everything that we're doing is through the YAML file, and that's why there is a really a good match between them. The second aspect on the GitOps, we're going to focus on the part of the Git. And on the Git, it should be the source, the single source of truth of your configuration, exactly as you have with your code. And when I say single source of truth, I can say, so like a joke, that a single configuration as truth. Because if, what is it? It's really that in your Git repository, you are going to put and to host the desired state of your specific Kubernetes cluster, which is going to help you to use and to benefit to all the advantage of traceability, visibility that Git provides. And all the change that you are going to do, it will be, everything will be really tracked. You will have an history. Everything will be to Git. That means that you will be able to do some rollback, to do some back forward, and to really be able to play with the configuration of a cluster using this Git capability. And the last part, so it's on the ops perspective, is really to be able to use so Git commit, the Git pull request or merge request in order to provision or to deploy any application. And this is really, really important because that's part, when I say that, so I mean, you are, if you are a developer, you are familiar with this kind of practice because you already apply this practice to your application development and your as a developer. And this is something that we would like to just to you know what you are going to do that for the code. And now we are going to do the same for the configuration. And for that, very simple. So about the delivery model, it's very simple. Exactly as you have with your source of code, you push your code into a Git repository. Then you have so CI/CD or any other process, to be able to build your release, your package, your application. And in the context of Kubernetes, it will be to build a container image that you are going to push into the image registry. And of course, for the configuration, it will be exactly the same. So you put your configuration, your YAML file, your Kubernetes resources into a Git repository. Then you will have a process who is going to apply this configuration into your different Kubernetes cluster. And that's it. I'm only say that, and for you, it should be really simple. And it is simple. There is nothing hide, nothing that it's not declared. The principle is as simple as that. And to be able to see what we are going to have on the CD, on the continuous delivery part, what we are going to use and what we are going to present, it's this tool, so Argo CD. So Argo CD is the declarative continuous delivery tool that leverages the GitOps to maintain multiple Kubernetes clusters. So it acts as a controller. So you will have Argo CD as a controller, which are going to continuously monitoring application definition, your definition, your Kubernetes resources defined into your Git repository, and is going to compare that definition with the state of your cluster, your current state of the cluster. So that means that Argo CD will be able to see any configuration drift. Configuration drift is when you do a change on your cluster, which is not defined into a Git repository. Really, really important when you want to do some recovery, failure recovery, and things like this. And of course, when you will be able to detect this change, you will be able to take the right action and to do some synchronization also for you. So you will have a lot of flexibility on that part. And the cool thing also with Argo CD is the fact that it supports Helm, customize, or other things in order to also continue to leverage this templatization of your YAML file to another level. For that, and just if we focus on Argo CD. So let's have a look on Argo CD. What's happening there? For sure, it's as usual, the demo effect. Let me check quickly. Demo effect. Okay. I'm just losing my my cluster right now. Oops. Okay, so let me just show you from another environment, because of course when we're doing live demo, it's really important to be able to have a different environment. To be able to packet that, just give me 2 seconds. Synchronize that. Okay, oops, and that, which is perfect. Let me show you this one. So this is what Argo CD look like. So basically on Argo CD, what you are going to define, it's very simple, application. And on these different applications, you are going to define the source and the target. From the source, as you can see here, so the source will be the same. So the source is really the Helm chart that I have. So my Git repository, my Helm chart. I have both Helm chart from my repository, my GitHub repository, the version 0.1.0. And what is changing, of course, is the target. So in which case I push my configuration into the test, my WordPress test environment. And in another one, it will be my WordPress prod environment. What is going to change between these two components also is not only the target, it's also the definition. And for that, we're going to leverage what we have with Helm in order to just define into the different definitions that I have here on the parameters. I'm going to change these parameters will be the variable. So here, so we're using, of course, the version 1.0, which is deploying in test environment in the dev mode and using one specific database. And if I have a look on the other, my other system, which is the prod environment, the prod application on the parameters, once again, based on the same Helm chart, what is changing is just the parameters. Using the same template, the same artifact, the same Kubernetes resources. And here I'm using a database that I deploy into a production environment. I deploy it on prod production mode, of course, and I'm using exactly the same tag, the same image on this part. So this is what we are with Argo CD, and as you can see here from my cluster that I need to show you, for example here, so nothing is deployed. So if I go here on my cluster, so this is a Kubernetes cluster. So the one that I'm using is the one from Red Hat, the OpenShift, but it's just to be able also to have a console and to have something more, more also visual. What I'm going to show you, it's a WordPress test. It's on my test environment. So right now from the test environment, as you can see here, let me switch here, nope. And my topology, so it's nothing, so it's loading, but we are going to see nothing on this part. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to use Helm in order to provide and to Helm and Argo CD in order to populate this environment. For that, it will be very simple. Let me change the view from here. I'm going to go to, for example, deploy. Which is perfect. Now I'm going back to, oops, here, I'm going back to my Argo CD environment, selecting my test environment, and I'm just going to click on synchronization. So I'm clicking on synchronization, and you are going to see that automatically, all the resources has been deployed on my test environment. Just before that, this environment was completely empty. And now it has been deployed with the right definition that I have with my Helm and especially the Helm test. You are going to see that all the dependencies, so I have services, I have deployment, I have routes, and I have a lot of different capabilities. like this, and I will be able to monitor absolutely everything. So now the synchronization, it's in progress. It is in progress because my code here, so for example here, I have some issue with this environment, but is not able to do some pull request, and I will be able to see that and to see that there is a specific problem in that part. But if we take, for example, from my secret, just to have a look on the secret, I take from my secret and I go back into here, I go back into the different information that I have. What I've deployed, it's my MariaDB secret, and from the MariaDB secret, I'm going just to add a drift. So this is open, this is open Slava here. I'm going to save it. I'm going to save it. So it's test. So this is open Slava. I'm save it. Oh, so illegal, which is dot Okay, so I'm not going to change it, but let me just open Slava tag. So just to add something there. So I add the open Slava at this part. And what is going to happen if I do some refresh? Oops, because it's still processing here. The thing is, so a detail here. So no, there is an issue with this environment. Oh God. So all the time with that, so restart, stop. So, okay, issue. But the goal of Argo CD is really to be able to say that when I change something into my my environment, it will be able to detect that change. So that means when I will have and to see what is happening into the difference, I will be able to see both difference. So what I have here on the cluster, so right now I have nothing, but what I would like to have and what is the desired state of my application. So this is what we have with Argo CD and how Argo CD is going to help you on that part. Then what we want to show, it's really to show also from the DevOps, from the entire CI/CD pipeline. So how you will be able to leverage, of course, Helm through Argo CD. So Helm to be able to have just the value, some value, some variable that you have to change, and to enable and to leverage your CI/CD pipeline by adding Argo CD in order to give this monitoring, detection drift, drift detection, so taking action or deployment capability to your CI/CD pipeline. So unfortunately, I will not be able to do this live demo because I have some issue with my cluster. But what I can show you is just about the act of the pipeline that I will be able to comment here. So here is an example of a pipeline. So this pipeline is using right now, so Tecton. So I'm using Tecton on that, but it will be available if you're using so Azure DevOps, GitLab CI, and other. And basically from the pipeline, what I have here, it's on the first part, I have my CI. So it's not something that is really interesting.
Guys, excuse me, I have to tell you that your time is almost up. So we need to wrap it up really quickly.
Okay, yes, perfect. Yes, so the CI, which is not important, but what is the process about that? It's the first of all, so it's going to clone the test, the configuration of my test environment. It's going to update the configuration from, it's going to update this test environment and to push into the Git repository. When it's done, Argo CD will be able to detect that change. And from this change, so it will be able to automatically see that there is a change into the Git repository and to apply that into the cluster. And of course, it's going to do that for the test environment. After that, it will use and it will apply some tests that we are going to do. And we are going to do exactly the same thing from the production environment in order to update our our application. So very briefly, I'm very sorry for that. So some live issue with the current cluster and with the demo. But it's basically how, with this demo, how you will be able really to use Helm to package your application and the configuration of your application and to leverage Argo CD. It's how you will be able to basically improve your CI/CD pipeline and of course improve the frequency and the consistency of your application and to push it into the end of your user. So yes, yeah.
Thank you guys.
Thank you.
That was wonderful, but I was able to understand something, and I'm really happy about that. When you do these nice graphs and everything, then I can understand. Cool. So, and these tasks can be automated. I'm really, really surprised what everything can be automated this way. And I'm really glad that you showed us how to do this easily, how to do it with Red Hat. And I would like to thank you guys and Red Hat, especially our platinum partner, for the help organizing this conference and for sending to smart brains to explain how to use Red Hat products to really simplify processes, which a couple of months and years ago took a much longer time. And you were able to explain it to me, which is like really, really something you can go for TED Talks or something like that. Thank you, Steven, and thank you, Madhu.
Thank you. Thank you to have us here.
Thank you.
Okay, everyone.
Okay. Have a good night. Bye.